Okay, we've covered almost all of the skills of CPR. Now let's add the assessment steps that lead up to compressions and breathing. First of all, you'll want to assess the victim's responsiveness. This starts with tapping the victim and shouting to get their attention.
Hey, are you okay? Sir, can you hear me? Mike, he's not responding.
I'll get help from the ED.
If the victim doesn't respond, activate the emergency response system if you are not EMS and get an AED. If you are in an out-of-hospital setting, you'll call either 911 or your local emergency response number. If you are in an in-hospital setting, you may generally call a code and get a crash cart.
Hey, are you okay? Sir, can you hear me? You, activate the emergency response system and get an AED.
Open the victim's airway and assess the victim by looking, listening, and feeling for adequate breathing. If the victim is not breathing adequately, give 2 breaths. Then, check the victim's pulse. Maintain a head tilt with one hand and locate the trachea, using 2 or 3 fingers of the other hand. Slide these fingers into the groove between the trachea and the muscles at the side of the neck, where the carotid pulse can be felt. Make sure you check for a pulse on the side closest to you. It's important to remember that you should spend at least 10 seconds trying to locate the pulse. 11, if you do not find the pulse within 10 seconds, move on to cycles of chest compressions and breaths. 20, 21.